Every time I talk to customer service leaders, we all agree that CSAT is kind of the metric we love to hate. People are nodding and laughing at me. It was fine, or was it? But you know, things are much different now, and things could be way better. We have way better ways to measure our customer experience. We shouldn't be relying on things like CSAT anymore. It has very poor coverage for a start. Less than half of customer conversations are ever sent a CSAT survey. Very few people reply. The responses are only at the extremes, like you see here. People who are very happy say they're very happy. People who are very angry say they're very angry. But everyone in the middle says nothing. And they're the silent majority. They're actually most of your customers don't actually tell you how they feel at all. And the people who do reply, the angry people are definitely angry, but some of the happy people are angry too, right? But they just told you they're happy because they didn't want to upset the poor person who might get in trouble. And you know, right? This is what we all notice. This is the world we live in. And yet, when we're reporting our performance to our company or even externally, we're using CSAT as the measure. But it's just not a good measure. Things can be way better. You can kind of see an illustration of the compounding effects of this. Less than half of people are sent a CSAT survey, and then the response rate is like 1 in 5, and you know, 21% to 39% is 8%. And so less than 10% of your customers' experience has actually been measured, which means 90% is not. The thing is, every conversation is recorded, right? So you can't see it, but it's there. It's all there. All the data is there. And finally, we have a technology in AI that gives us access to it. AI can analyze every single conversation and every single word of every single conversation. And loads of our customers for months now have been asking us, please give us a window into this world. And so that's what we're going to do. That's what we've built. The first part of this is a new metric, a much better way to measure your customer experience. It is called the customer experience score, very imaginative. CX score for short. It's an AI-powered metric. It evaluates every customer conversation and every word of every conversation. So that's the CX score. It lets you see the full picture. This is our data from April. You can see here, CSAT survey, we got less than 5,000 responses despite our best efforts. But the CX score gave us over 30,000 full conversations, not just the response, not that I'm happy or I'm sad, the full conversation. These are like, you know, completely different data sets to work with. So it's really, really comprehensive. It's got three inputs. The first input is resolution status. So that is, was the issue resolved? And if people had multiple issues in one conversation, were all of the issues resolved? The second thing is customer sentiment. How do they feel? Were they happy, frustrated? You might have a resolution, the thing was solved, and a very unhappy customer, right? And that is not a good customer experience. So resolution status and customer sentiment. You can discern people's language, how they feel. And third is service quality. So what was the service quality like? Was the response clear? Was it helpful? Was it efficient? And then these three things together give you your CX score, and it's just a way better measure. It's a way more comprehensive, holistic measure of actual customer experience. Here's how it works. Every conversation gets a CX score from 1 to 5. You can kind of see the screenshot here. At the very top of every single customer conversation, you have a CX score and a summary of why the conversation got that score. So you can see the explanation for the score, the reasoning for the score, as well as the score itself. This works for Fin, but it also works for all human conversations. So you literally have Fin and humans. Every single customer conversation gets a CX score. You might ask, hey, Paul, that sounds great in theory, but like, can I trust it and you? We have rigorously tested this. You know, Owen kind of mentioned earlier, at Intercom, we're a very proud product-building company. It's our kind of heritage and our DNA. We take a lot of pride in delivering really high-quality products to you. And we kind of tested this. We sat on this for a while to make sure that it is truly, rigorously, scientifically, statistically robust. And the way we did that is that we first had the best human agents that we have manually review thousands of conversations. Manually review thousands of conversations. We then had our CX score review those same conversations. And then we used a method called an F-score analysis to compare the two. Look for false positives and false negatives and look for like the kind of differences and similarities. And the CX score performed phenomenally well. It basically is very, very close to human judgment. And this is what our very, very best customer service reps. So we've tested it. We think it's really robust. Our customers who are using it believe that too. So we've really, really tried to make sure this is something that we hope the industry will adopt. Our customers love using the CX score. Here is Jared from CultureAmp, one of our great customers, saying how this has just changed how they operate, changed how they think. It's actually changed their mindset. They can see every conversation clearly now. We hope and think that CX score will replace CSAT. We think it's just a much better thing for the industry to adopt. Franca in our own team said it better than anyone else could. You can't fix what you can't see. And now with CX score, you can see. You can see everything. Okay, so CX score is a core part of the Insights product, but the Insights product is much bigger than that. It's not just the CX score. It's a set of tools for you to understand fully how your customers think, how they feel, what they say about you, your product, your brand, your company itself, and then ultimately to optimize the customer experience that you deliver to them. So first, we look at the performance dashboard. This is where you obviously monitor your overall support performance. You can see here at the top, we have CX score, obviously, on the right. But we also have resolution rate, and we have involvement rate. Resolution rate is where was the query resolved. Involvement rate was how many times did Fin actually try and answer the question. And these are three things that you can kind of look at, see how they're performing, and start to, using the loop, start to understand, okay, how do I improve these things, drive up resolution rate, improve my CX score, get Fin more involved more often, free up our team to do more valuable work. You can also see how things are trending, of course, and that's the performance dashboard. But once you've got a sense of performance, like how does Fin perform, how does our human team perform, what's our full service operation performance like, the second question, of course, is, what's driving the performance? What's making it go up? What's making it go down?